Good evening. I'm Bob Chalmick with Joanne Stefanik and Larry Langley from Edmonton's Newsday.
Ask any Oiler fan in the city and they will tell you that the Stanley Cup is coming home tonight. People, in fact, are counting on it. Some are already celebrating. Rick Boguski has the story.
From the air, everything appears calm. On the ground, Oiler fever has taken hold. School children unable to concentrate on their schoolwork. Classroom after classroom, banners and screaming kids.
There you go, Daisy.
Bank tellers willing to bet you money the Oilers are going to win.
It's my birthday today, so they're bound to win tonight and bring home the cup.
Working at the supermarket, wishing instead they were at home in front of the TV set.
I've got 7 more hours to go, and I feel like a lifetime before I can go home and watch the game.
This is a town just waiting for an Oiler victory, waiting for the Stanley Cup to come home again for the 5th time in 7 years. And if it happens tonight, it's quite likely Jasper Avenue will be packed full of cheering fans.
City crews were already taking precautions this afternoon, bringing out their no parking signs to control traffic along Jasper Avenue. Barricades sat ready, waiting to be used too. Police expect they'll have more than 100 officers down here. But what if the Oilers don't win tonight?
Well, then they'll win the next game.
Rick Boguski, CBC News, Edmonton.
The Oilers have got to win tonight.
Yes.
The weather has been a little damp of late, and it's going to be damper tonight.
Well, should there be a celebration downtown, they may be celebrating in the rain. There are thunderstorms around tonight, and we look for 25 millimeters, which is more than we had in this area last night, up to 30 millimeters expected in the Calgary area from thunderstorms. And there are weather advisories out for heavy rain in the western Edson region and the Red Deer region and the Calgary region into the foothills, where they could get 50 millimeters or more. So it could be a wet one, and it's going to rain here again tomorrow.
Okay.
Join us after the game, should the Oilers win, which they will, of course. We'll go live to Chris Cuthbert in Boston and to Jasper Avenue. Thanks for watching.
Once again, hockey night in Canada salutes the Edmonton Oilers Stanley Cup champions 1990. The players on the ice celebrating. On the Oilers bench, they're celebrating. And the crowd is now standing. And they, too, salute the Edmonton Oilers.
At Edmonton's Newsday, salute the Edmonton Oilers as well. A high five. We've got joy in Edmonton tonight. I'm Bob Chalmick with Joanne Stefanik. We also have concern in Edmonton tonight. There is an emergency in Refinery Row.
That's right, Bob. The other big story tonight, there's been an explosion at the Petro-Canada refinery on Refinery Row. If you can see the smoke to the right of your screen where the smoke starts, that is where the blaze, the explosion reportedly started. We sent a reporter out. We've got Rick Boguski standing by to fill us in. Rick, what's going on out there right now?
Well, police have confirmed there was an explosion, Joanne, but they say it's now under control. We really can't see much from where we are. Police have blocked all roads into the Petro-Can site. But from where we're standing right now, it appears that the fire is now out, because earlier there was quite a large flame. Now there's just a white puff of smoke.
And quite a bit of concern, because when we first heard about this, they were calling it an emergency situation. Have there been any injuries that you know of?
Well, I asked police about that, and they say that they haven't confirmed if there have been any injuries yet, although we've seen 3 ambulances go by. And Alberta Public Safety say that they're treating this as a major explosion.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Rick. You're going to stay out there and keep us posted. We should have more details and more pictures within the hour for our audience to look at. We've just been told, by the way, that the University of Alberta Hospital is expecting as many as 4 people.
And it looks like the smoke has just been put out, that fire.
So just to recap, there was an explosion earlier this evening, just about at the end of the hockey game, at the Petro-Canada plant on Refinery Row. 6 units were sent from the Strathcona Fire Department to fight that explosion. Again, RCMP in the area have blocked access to the refinery from Highway 16A. We've been told that flame and smoke were visible for about a mile from the refinery. And again, the University Hospital is expecting 4 people as a result of that explosion. Again, we have Rick Boguski on the scene, and he'll keep us up to date on this breaking story.
Okay, another story tonight, and it's a big one. Well, they wanted it in the City of Champions, and the City of Champions is again on top of the world tonight. The pride of Edmonton is the class of the NHL, and Lord Stanley's Cup is coming home where it belongs. The parties have begun wherever Oiler fans are gathered, and we take you to the big one, traditionally anyway. It's downtown. Brett Harris is standing by live on Jasper Avenue. Hi, Brett.
Hi, Bob and Joanne. I'm down here on Jasper Avenue and 103rd Street, where I seem to have attracted a pretty big crowd. As you can see, the party's really started to pick up here. It's been raining here for about an hour now, off and on, sometimes pretty steadily, but it doesn't seem to be deterring these people. Jasper has been blocked off for about an hour and a half now, and it's not quite full yet, but it's getting that way. Yeah. They're coming from everywhere. So there are a lot of police down here, too. They seem determined to keep things under control. But I haven't seen too many people with open liquor or anything yet. But I think that it looks like they're going to be able to keep things under wraps tonight. It may depend on the rain. Anyway, we'll keep you updated.
Thanks very much, Fred. I think we're going to have to get him a megaphone. You think there's a party down on Jasper Avenue. You want to be in Boston tonight because the Oilers are certainly celebrating a long ways away from home in a dressing room at the Boston Garden. And, of course, our Chris Cuthbert is there. We watched him earlier tonight, soaked with champagne. Chris, talk to us.
Here we go. All right, the party is continuing here at the Boston Garden, and we've got many of the partiers with us, starting with Mark, the Messier family over here. Maybe we can get some introductions.
What's up? This is my sister Jenny, Jenny Blum, who's married to John Blum, who's a part of the Bruins organization, and this is the first cup that we've spent together, so we're pretty happy. Hi, Mom, hi, Dad, hi, family, hi, Paul, Mary Kay.
All right, Mark, it was so exciting before. I'm not sure that we really got a chance to talk about your feeling first time that the president has handed you the Stanley Cup.
Well, I don't think that was really important. I didn't feel any real significance to me accepting the trophy. I accepted it on part of the Oiler organization because obviously it takes a whole organization to win it, and it was a tremendous feeling to accept it on behalf of the organization, but what more can you say?
I don't know when it's going to sink in, but what a year. It was a Hart Trophy year, a Stanley Cup year. I don't know what more you could have done.
Well, I don't know if we could have done another game. That probably might have been it. I always say it's like the Thrill of Manila with Ali and Fraser. You know, Ali said he couldn't come out for another round, but I guess if he had to, he probably would have. And Fraser folded, and here we are with Stanley Cup.
200 points tonight, too. You keep writing more history.
Well, I guess those things will be nice to look back on later in my career, but, hopefully I have a few more years left in me, and we can do this again.
This is fun because you've got family in Boston. Are you enjoying winning it on the road?
Not. I would prefer to win it at home. I guess you can't be choosy when you're playing for something that's a Stanley Cup, but obviously winning at home is a special feeling, not only because my family's there, but there's a lot of fans that are diehard Oilers fans for a long time, and it's nice to go out in Edmonton and celebrate with the people. But we're coming home tomorrow. Edmonton is right on board.
Well, it was special watching Mark Messier, that's for sure, this year. Congratulations again. Bill Tuwele's here because we've got a lot of important business to take care of. But number one, you are coming home tomorrow.
We are.
What kind of scene is it going to be like at the airport, and what's planned?
Well, I can't predict what's going to happen at the airport, but we're arriving at 3:05, and I would assume that based on past experiences and the fact that there were a lot of people out there after the Campbell Conference victory, that there'll be the odd Edmonton Oiler fan out at the airport. We're expecting you there. We're getting there around 3:00. We hope to land on time and hope to see all Edmontonians very soon. Of course, there's some other excitement coming up too, I think.
You better tell us about what civic plans there are.
I don't know them all, but I was talking to Alderman Helen Paul, and I don't want to seem arrogant, but we did do a little pre-planning. I know it's Sunday.
Now, the last time the city planned in advance, you were upset with them,
because they announced it, but before we won. But we're going to be at Commonwealth Stadium. It's going to be a huge rally at Commonwealth Stadium. No parade, no drive-by. Anything that was negative in the past about the Oilers parade, victory parades, there will be no cocktail receptions or anything. The Oilers will be at Commonwealth Stadium on Sunday afternoon. Barry, you'll be there. And that's it.
All right.
We're going to be there about 2. I'm not sure, but I think it's about 2 o'clock.
Okay, thanks very much to Bill Tuwele. One of the reasons this is so entertaining and it will be so much fun this year is because the young guys, Martin Gelinas, is celebrating his first Stanley Cup, and you must really be full of emotion.
Ben oui, man, that's just great. I mean, that's a great feeling to be to win a Stanley Cup right now, and it's just, you know, when you got a great organization like Edmonton and great player like Messier, Tikkanen, and Curry try to do the same thing every time, and just want to say I love the people of Edmonton. Champagne for you.
One of the great things about the youngsters is Joe Murphy's family was able to be here. Adam Graves' family drove down from Toronto today, and I know you spent some moments with your family back there.
Well, I mean, that's just great. I think they deserve everything, you know, like they really encouraged me also, you know, for a couple of years when I was young, and I mean, that they really deserve to be here tonight, and win a Stanley Cup from them, that's just, I think they're really happy about it.
You're allowed to sleep in tomorrow.
Well, I don't know. We will see.
Martin, congratulations on just a fantastic year, and we look forward, I know, the fans in Edmonton for many great years of hockey.
Thanks a lot.
All right, we're going to hopefully come back to the dressing room here. It's starting to empty out, but we'll have a few more players for you a bit later. Now back to Edmonton.
Here we go.
Wow, it sure looks like a good time in the dressing
room. He's
dried
himself off a wee bit.
Well, a bit, but Chris was just doused when I got in the dressing room.
Didn't Messier look great? I mean, talk about happy. I know he said it was better to win at home, but I don't know if he could look any more pleased than he looked there with his sister.
And his sister was pretty happy, too.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't that long ago that the Oilers won their fourth Stanley Cup. A lot, obviously, has happened since then. There was, of course, the Gretzky trade and John Muckler taking over the team as head coach. And while a lot has changed, you know, the result is one that we've seen before. Gord Miller looks back at the first four, the first four Stanley Cups.
There's a new punch on the block. In the National Hockey League, the Edmonton Oilers, by name, the Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
Who can forget the heady days of 1984 when the brash young Edmonton Oilers, led by Wayne Gretzky, Mark Messier, and Paul Coffey, knocked the New York Islanders off the top of the NHL heap. The Oilers had been to the final a year earlier and lost. Now they were first-time champions. And even though they had won only once, a great deal was expected. Already the word dynasty was being used. The team was young, had a world of talent, and a bright future in front of it. Seldom had so much been expected of a new Stanley Cup champion. And in 1985, they delivered, losing only three games in the playoffs in perhaps their most dominating postseason performance. That series against the Flyers brought some hard feelings, but also brought to Edmonton what fans wanted the most, a second Stanley Cup. But a third championship would have to wait until 1987.
Anderson and Messier again. Anderson, goal!
1987 saw the seven-game nail-biter between the Oilers and the Flyers. It came down to the final period of the final game, but Glenn Sather, John Muckler and company came out with the victory and Stanley Cup number three. They would be back for a fourth in 1988. But not before the drama of the Boston Garden. The lights went out on Game 4, and so the Oilers returned home to win it on Coliseum ice again.
The Edmonton Oilers have won it again!
A four-game sweep of the Boston Bruins. The Oilers once again, at the height of their powers, posed for a team picture on the ice after the game. Few could have known that Wayne Gretzky would be traded 3 months later. But while number 99 left, the Stanley Cup would return to Edmonton 2 years later. As the beat goes on.
The beat goes on, and now it's five.
That's right.
Well, there are a lot of people down on Jasper Avenue in downtown Edmonton who look almost as drenched as Chris Cuthbert, and Brett Harris is with them, but it's raining down there.
Oh, lots of people.
Thanks, Bob and Joanne. I'm down here. It's really starting to rain now, but as I said before, that's not deterring any of these people. I got a few diehard hockey fans. We can just get them to talk. I got Mike here. Mike, where'd you just come from?
Oh, I just came from work, and I heard the score was 5-1, Edmonton.
Were you watching the game at all?
No, I wasn't watching the game at all.
Are you a diehard Oilers fan?
Diehard, Edmonton, all the way.
So what do you think about today's win?
A blowout. They should have did it in four, but we'll take five.
What's your name?
My name is Carmen Caputo. The Oilers are the awesomest team of the 90s and the 80s.
Well, I guess that's about all that you can say. Back to the desk. We'll talk to you later.
Slowly but surely.
Awesomest? Yeah, I think we'll have to look that one up. The Awesomest. Well, we have an awesome reporter standing by. We're going to go back to Chris. He's in Boston at the Garden in the dressing room. Chris?
Well, we haven't dried out yet, that's for sure. Steve Smith's with us. Steve, another marvelous playoff year for you. Your thoughts?
Well, I'm all pretty excited about this. You know, it was a team that went through a lot of adversity, and I think we all hung together real tight and went through an awful lot together, and we're pretty excited and pretty proud of each other.
Your partner, Rayo Ruotsalainen, had certainly added a little to this hockey club down the stretch.
Well, there's no doubt that he's just such a pure offensive player, such a pep back there in defense, and the rest of us slugs, we just tried to get it up and around the boards and get it to our forwards, and he put us in a situation where our defense became a little bit dangerous.
Steve, I know you want to say hi to a few people.
Well, I want to say hi to my daughter, Alex, back in town, and my wife, Sherry.
All right, Steve Smith. Here's one of the lows, Ken Lowe. How many rings do the Lowe's have? You must have won a couple with the Eskimos, and Kevin's got a pretty good collection.
I won one in my rookie season with the Eskimos in 82, and I won one in 87. In my rookie season in hockey, I've done it again.
And this is special, too, because it's anniversary day.
Yeah, today's my 10th anniversary. I'd like to say to my wife, Marianne, and, of course, my daughter. I wish she could be here, but we'll celebrate definitely when we get home.
Make no mistake about it. As you can hear, these are the important guys, Lyle Kulchiski, Barry Stafford. These are the training staff, the equipment people, and guys, you've been through this before, five apiece for you two.
They're all sweet. Every one of them sweet. Just want to say hi to all my sisters back home. We're bringing a couple of girls.
And a special hello also to Banff, Alberta, Canada, and all our friends and family at home. Thanks.
And let's say hello to Mary.
All right. I'll tell you, we didn't get that big a reaction from the players, but here's a couple of players who had another great game today. You guys look like you're on a mission. Glenn Anderson, Craig Simpson.
Mission, I don't know. Are we on a mission? We destroyed the other team. I don't think we're on a mission now.
We played hard. It was a great series, and this guy came up big for us.
No, this guy came up big for us.
Well, I think you both came up big. Glenn, how do you compare this with the others?
Big. This one's sweet. I mean,
Go for it.
I mean, everyone's
I think it's better. It's got to be better because we came together so much more at the end of the year, and the new adaptions to our hockey team were incredible. Chuck, I know I look funny, don't I?
No mustache.
That's a first. When was the last?